Brothers and sisters, the Lord is with you.
And also with you.
We continue listening to God speak to us from the Gospel in the tradition of Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. Coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have had no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy, called Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing is impossible. Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done to me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her. This is the gospel, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
By the words of the gospel, may our sins be blotted out.
Amen.
So we gather tonight, and as always, we thank God we can be here to pray together and to hear God's word in the scriptures. We have a little bit of a different fourth week of Advent. The fourth week of Advent will be over within 24 hours. Thank God every week. Time goes fast enough. But in God's time, there is no set time. We listen to the Advent story, and the main characters, so to speak, are Gabriel, Elizabeth, John, Joseph, and Mary. We have two mothers, Elizabeth and Mary, both very different in their attitudes. One is asked a question, and we heard the reply, "Be it done to me according to your word." The other didn't have an opportunity to say anything. Her husband was dumb for 9 months because he questioned God's plan. And you might say, Mary might have questioned God's plan too, but she didn't, because she was open to what the angel said to her. Basically, that with God, nothing is impossible. And then we hear about another individual, Joseph. And the interesting interesting thing about Joseph is that this person utters no words in the scripture. There is no word in any of it, either in Luke or in Matthew's gospel, that Joseph speaks. Joseph is faithful. He is the one who teaches Jesus how to be a good Jew, how to be teaching him what he's going to need to be a provider for his mother after Joseph dies. I remember many years ago, the first class I taught in Brooklyn, I was teaching fifth grade. And at that point, we had what were called grade patrons. And the grade patron for the fifth grade in the Diocese of Brooklyn was Joseph. And when we came to March 19th, St. Joseph's Day, I said, Joseph is listed in the scripture as the best man. What does that mean? I said, man. And these 45 fifth grade boys are looking at me. Finally, this one hand goes up, and at that point, it was Mr. Spina. That means that Joseph was just a man, and Jesus is God. Quite a theological statement from the first word. Quite. Those of us who have been in the classroom have a lot of good memories. Sometimes we wonder, for all those, in my case, all those young men are at this point. Then we go back to Mary. Mary is open to God's word. She's open to God's word. She's obedient to God's word. And another word that thinking about preparing for tonight, that we don't usually hear in regards to Mary is that she was very vulnerable. Maybe unschooled, probably unschooled. In her day, if you were a young girl, the only thing you were taught was how to cook and clean house and prepare for a husband. And yet, the openness of this young woman is what brings about what we celebrate tomorrow. She was open because she understood that with God, nothing is impossible. So we get tonight, and with the extended penance service that we had, and with Mary's openness to God's word, hopefully each one of us can say in our own way, in our own way, in our own time, be done to me, O God, according to your word. Pray for me as I pray for you. And may God bless us and keep us. May God's face shine upon us. Give us peace, now and always.
Amen. Amen.